efficient project management. Efficiency, as you know, is less effort and more impact. And project management is a complex thing, but basically it means getting the work done efficiently. Now, when we talk about work and project, it's complex, lot of tasks, lot of resources, costs, but let's start simple. We do two types of work, my own work and where others are involved. This itself can be classified into further my work, which I'll do on my own, and something I'll delegate to others. This is typically done using Outlook tasks. If you want to delegate it to someone, you use Outlook tasks and use the assign task button. I'm not going to go into details of that. Now, if you want a shared task list, you can't share your Outlook task list. So what do? So now we have Teams and Planner where you can have a shared task list and people can see what others are doing and get their job done as a team. Now, what we are going to talk about today is tasks which are linked to each other. None of these three categories tasks are linked to each other. When one task gets delayed, others don't get affected. It's a flat list. So for linked tasks, we need some project management tool, and I'm going to cover Microsoft Project today. So my own work, two steps. First, make a task list. But making a task list alone is not enough. You need to find time to do the work. So drag your tasks into calendar, block the time to do your own work, and you will be able to manage your time better. That's all I'm going to talk about, personal kind of work. Personal means corporate work, but my own work. So shared work, Teams and Planner. Many of you must have used SharePoint earlier. That's why I put it, but I put it on a side because in fact, Teams and Planner themselves use SharePoint behind the scenes. So you don't need to directly use SharePoint, but if you want to, you can use a SharePoint shared task list as well. And now, how do you add a planner to Teams? You just go to Teams, add a tab button, which is a plus sign, and choose Planner. When you add planner there, what happens? You can add tasks and you get a board like this. You can categorize the tasks. Tasks can be seen in their current state. This means partially complete. Completed tasks are collapsed at the bottom. Having done that, many times we do reviews, periodic reviews. Primary purpose of the review is to understand what is done, what is not done, what is pending. Now that's no longer required because in the same view, you can just say group by progress and you get the same thing recast as sort of a Kanban view. So not started, progress, completed. Even people who use Agile use this as a backlog and sprint one, sprint two, and it does get done much better than before. Now, if I'm a part of multiple teams, each team will have a planner task list, but across these projects, I will have my own tasks. I don't want to go to each of them manually one by one and find out where my name is. So Planner also gives you a centralized place called My Tasks where you can see my tasks across projects. And there is a button, I don't have time to show the demo, which can add these tasks directly to your Outlook. So you don't have to go to this screen ever again. Having done this, these are all unstructured, unlinked tasks. Now, when we talk about project management, it can get very complex, but at a very simple level, this is what we are talking about. Someone makes a list of tasks, then we go and decide who is going to do what, estimate costs and maybe put them there or put it somewhere else. And then this is being done by the person in charge, a project manager, but that person has to inform others what are they supposed to do when. And then get the progress info from those people, update the progress. Of course, there will be periodic reviews and monitoring and then create those reports and adjust the project as it goes along. This already happens, am I right? Now the question is, how does this happen? Tell me if this is correct. Does this happen in Excel? Yes, no. So how many people use Microsoft Project for this? Okay, few. Now, as you already know, I am always talking about Office and Excel, but this is an exception. You should not use Excel for project management, not just because I am telling you, but there are very specific reasons for it. First thing is, you will typically put date calculations. You'll put a column called task, you'll put a column called start date, you'll put a column called duration. And then the next start starts based on a formula. Previous task endpoint plus, you take that and add it. That is wrong, because when you say duration, it does not include weekends. So always your calculations are wrong. And generally we take the previous task end date as the starting date of next task. That is also wrong. It should be next plus one, because it starts on the next day. So inherently it is flawed. Very soon the formulas become so complex that we just don't bother about them, basically making it inaccurate. We don't allocate resources. We just put names of people in a column. But if there is a work which is done in 10 days, you put one person's name and then you add one more person, that should shrink to 5 days. That doesn't happen because we haven't put a formula. So it's not realistic. Not only that, when you put someone's name in that column, that person has no clue that you have assigned that task to that person. That person will come to know about it much, much later. By that time, it is too late. So there are many reasons. I don't want to go into details. Basically, it gives you a false sense of project management. And on top of it, Excel does not create Gantt charts. So we manually create small cells and formatting and waste our precious life trying to create a simulated Gantt, which is always wrong. So many of you do use Microsoft Project. What does it do? It manages all this without writing a single formula, because all these project management related formulas are pre-built. You don't have to type them. Project understands them. Now, if you're already using Project, what are we doing? We are creating multiple tasks linked to a common goal. Typically, what happens in project management is this. Most often, it becomes a Gantt chart drawing tool, which is easier than doing it in Excel. Which is okay, you can use it for that. But later on, the types of tasks are not changed. We just add tasks, tasks, tasks. You don't realize that there are three types of tasks: fixed duration, fixed work, and fixed units. Most people don't even know what these three mean. And even if you know them, it's not enough to know them. For each task, you have to decide the correct type. Otherwise, the calculations are wrong. And then generally it is used for planning because it's under the control of PM. But when it comes to managing people, again the same problem. If you add a resource name, that resource doesn't know project manager is blocking my time for 1 week for this project, 3 months down the line. So it's still inaccurate. Resources are added, but how much the resources cost is typically not added. That's again giving you wrong estimates. Costs themselves, like travel, stay, transport, are not added as tasks. They should be. And baseline is very rarely saved. Even if it is saved, we should have up to 11 baselines and interim things which are not done. Bottom line, even if you are using MS Project, you are not using it optimally. Now let's say, for argument's sake, you are not making any of the mistakes which I showed you on the previous slide. Then what? At least then you are managing project correctly. Probably that particular project, yes. But there is no company in the world which manages one project. Hundreds of projects are going on in different departments. They may have multiple resources and lots of money involved. So what happens then? Typically, when we use MS Project, we create MPP files, save as local file. So what happens then? The resource allocation is wrong because the resources don't know. I already mentioned that. Now, when the time comes to track the project, the PM has to copy paste tasks by group, by person, and mail it to them so that they know what's supposed to be done. Okay, that's not a one-time job because project schedule keeps changing. So this is a repetitive activity. If there is a conflict, I added someone 3 months down the line, some other project also blocked that person, that conflict will be noticed at too late a point in time. Finally, if you have multiple projects, they are scattered all over the organization, and some team is paid salary just to copy paste and create reports. It's a disaster. And central reporting is repetitive, and because it's repetitive and manual, it takes too long. So by the time the management is looking at the report, it's already outdated. So agile project management can never happen. That's the whole problem. So the better approach is to use MS Project, even if you are using as a single efficiently. And if you want to do all this properly, you cannot use MS Project alone. You have to use MS Project plus MS Project Online. Now, because I'm demonstrating it, I'm using Microsoft Project and Project Online. There is Artemis, there is Primavera, there are many other tools available. Which tool you use doesn't matter. It has to be used in the right way. So Project Server, how many of you have seen or used Project Server? Very, very few. Actually, it is now called Project Online. It was earlier called Project Server. It was an on-premise thing and it was extremely complex to set up and manage. So many people got, even if they wanted it functionally, they got put off because of the complexity. So now, even if you know Project Online, why don't we use it? Because many people don't know it. Cost is one factor. It was complex to set up and maintain, and that led to bad experience and users never used it. So all that is gone now. Now it is simple and pre-integrated. So I'm going to show you the main difference between just using Microsoft Project and using Project with Project Online. The primary difference comes as to where you save the files. Typically, we save files to desktop and each file is independent. They don't understand each other. So consolidation is your responsibility. Whereas when you save it on Project, what happens? This is not your responsibility. You save the file directly to Project Online. There is no local file available. There is a cached version, but it's linked to the server. So let's see how this works. This is a long list. I'm not going to read out everything in detail. I'll actually show you the entire life cycle and then you take a call. Now, this is a demo which is clicked through because I want to save time. But each slide is a step. I'm not performing the step, it's just a screenshot. Now, each screenshot is either done in Project Desktop or Project Online. Project Online doesn't have a logo of its own, so this is Project Online for our purpose. There are two users involved, project manager and a resource or a person who is going to do the work or user. So PM and you. So in the top right corner, for each step, you will see some of these icons to tell you where is this happening and who is doing it, which will give you a better understanding. So when you start project, normally we work locally. This time we connect to Project Online. Who is doing this? Project manager. Where is it happening? On Project Desktop. So you get the idea. Now, I'm not going to tell you how to draw a Gantt chart. That's fairly simple. That's not the point. So I have some tasks here. But one thing you should always do is the last task is project complete. And that's a milestone. Milestone has zero duration. Of course, tasks can be broken down into subtasks. This is a main task. These are subtasks. Another best practice is project itself should be a large summary task that can be added automatically. So this is called project summary task. Having done this, this file is not yet saved. Now, when we want to save as, this is the main difference. You don't save it to local drive, no OneDrive, no SharePoint. You share it with Project Online. Next step, again, this is Project Manager Desktop. Now, when you do this, because we want to consolidate projects across the organization, when we combine projects across the organization, the central team, PM or whatever you call it, they are getting assorted projects. And what are they doing? They are saying which department, which function, which SBU, and they are mapping it manually again and again, every week, every month. So that can be eliminated by creating custom fields here, which can be made mandatory. So at the outset itself, the project gets classified. Right now, I have only one field called department. You can create any number of such fields. Having done that, we save the project. Now, when we save the project, there is no local file. Next step is to add people. Who is supposed to do what? Yes, like Excel, we put the names of people, but these names cannot be arbitrarily put without knowing whether that person is going to go on leave 3 months later, or is that person blocked later on at the same time by another project. So first thing we have to do is create a central pool of resources. I have created a sample list. Now these are actual people. Financial analysts and programmer are called generic resources because in early stage of planning, you don't know who exactly is going to be a part of the project. But you know, you need a mechanical engineer, you need a financial analyst, which one will be replaced later. So these are specific, these are generic. Now, where do these resources come from? They can be imported from Active Directory in one stroke. You don't have to manually type anything. Having done that, you can add cost information, availability information, and so on to make that centralized resource pool more relevant and up to date. Now, the best part is all project managers will use the same list of people to allocate work. So if there is a conflict, it will be understood much earlier in the planning stage rather than much later. So how do I do that? So now I'm back to desktop, the same project manager is handling. So in the resource tab, there is add resources and build team from enterprise, means take the centralized resource pool. Having done that, what do you do? On the left side, we have all the available people, and on the right side, you choose what you want to include. We are actually building a team for this project. You can include external vendors as well. Just create a temporary AD link for AD account for them. Now, at this stage, if I want to know, this is a very important resource. Is this person available? How is this person available? I can see live availability online for every resource as a graph, and there are multiple views of this. Having done this, adding a resource is as simple as typing the name here. Now, of course, this is the presence icon. Assistant is online, boss, I don't know what he's doing, but that also integrates here. So from here, if I hover my mouse, I can chat. All the integration which we know about Skype and Teams is also available here. Having done this, what have I done? I have added tasks, I have given them durations, I have linked them to each other, and I have said who is going to do what. At this stage, have I put a single formula anywhere? Nothing. I have just typed. This list itself can be imported from your existing Excel if required. At this stage, it gives you automatic statistics because, as I said, project has everything built in. All these formulas are already built in. So it knows what is the duration, what is the work involved, and how much is the cost. How does it know the cost? Because when we added resources, we have given their rates. We can have standard as well as overtime rates if it is applicable. This can be in different currencies. By the way, project supports multi-currency projects. So one user can be in dollars, another can be in rupees. It need not be per hour. You can say per year, per month, per week, any unit goes, and then it will do the calculation. So this is how live statistics is available at any point of time. Now, it's not just saving the project. We already saved it. Now that we have finalized who is going to do what, we publish it. There's a difference between saving and publishing. Earlier, we used to save our MPP file locally, nothing happened. It's entirely up to you to copy paste from it. When you save and publish, it gets stored on the server, it gets automatically integrated with other projects, and all the resources get automatic email saying you are supposed to do this for this project on this date, well in advance. You are not copy pasting, you are not sending a mail to all the resources ever. Now, how often do you save, how often do you publish? As a project manager, you may be tweaking the project. That time you don't publish, you just save. When it is finalized, any major update, then you publish so people get informed. Having done this, as soon as you publish, it says it's not only the MPP file or the project task list. There will be documents associated with the project. There will be risks, issues, deliverables, RFPs, so many other things which cannot go in the MPP file. So it automatically creates a SharePoint site for it, which is predefined template designed for associating with the project management site. You can customize that site as well. Now, we are still the PM, but now we are seeing what happens on the online part. When you go to project online, what do you see? You see all these things. One of them is called projects. So when I click on it, what you see is like a Gantt chart. And we know Gantt chart, every row is a task. But surprisingly here, what has happened? All your projects have automatically got consolidated. Each row here is not a task, it's a project by itself. So you get a combined enterprise view without lifting your finger. This view can be made available read-only to all the bosses and stakeholders who need to see it. That eliminates unwanted meetings and gives you a live picture. Having done this, now let's see what happens. I published this project and I had assigned some tasks to this guy called assistant. So now this is the user called assistant. Now users do not need to touch the MPP file or MS project. MS project, they don't need, they just need a browser. When you go to a browser, they will go to Outlook. or on the mobile, wherever, and they will get a notification. So all assignments are automatically sent. As a user, when I open the assignment, I will see details about what is to be done. When is it to be done? If there is a dispute, if I need training, if I am not free, all that can be resolved well in advance. Now at this stage, the due date may or may not have appeared. This is just for my information. I can plan my time better. Now I get many such email messages. Notice this is a task, this is one task. This is all scattered. I'll keep getting these notifications. But if I want to know what is my task list across projects, I don't have to go and search for these mails. What do? I have another thing called tasks. And all this is happening on browser. Now when I go to my task as a user online, what am I seeing? I am seeing the project name and only the tasks which are assigned to me. This maintains confidentiality and it also makes it very convenient for project manager, because today half the project manager's time is going in informing people and asking people, what did you do? What is the progress? People just don't respond. Now, not only can I see my task, if I finish a task, I just go here and I say how much percent complete, or I can say actual hours which I have spent on the task. If you are in IT or where time is billable, you can also create very sophisticated timesheets where you can capture hourly work and then allocate it to relevant tasks. Both ways is possible. Here I am showing you task level. Now if this person says the task is complete, it does not update the project. Project manager now is looking at approvals online. So project manager will see the status update. If this person wants, they can accept or decline or change the number. This workflow is built in. You don't need a workflow software for this. You can customize this workflow. Sometimes when I add a resource, there is a resource manager, that team's boss who has to approve, will I allow this person to go for this project. So that resource manager approval is also built in, which I am not showing. So when you confirm the approval, when you confirm the update, you have to update the project. For that, you have to open the project on desktop, because the project desktop has a very sophisticated project management calculation engine, which is not replicated on server. So it has to happen on desktop. So open the project on desktop and say check progress. So whatever updates have been approved will be updated. And notice this guy called assistant said this task is done, so it is marked as complete. Without anybody sending a mail to each other, anybody following up, what have you done? And it is lightweight, browser-based, it can be done from mobile as well. So this is the entire cycle. Now notice, earlier we had this project statistics and we had some work here, 80 hours of work and 37,000. Now what has happened? The work has reduced because some work was finished faster. The cost has reduced and it's saying what is the remaining work and what is the actual work, what is the remaining cost and actual cost. Again, all this happened without writing a single formula. Now, if you go to the central view again, now we are as a PM, we are going here, and on project online, even that is updated to show partial progress of this project. Having done this, now we need reports. How do we do reports? No copy paste is involved. What do? You go to Power BI. Power BI has a built-in integration with project. You don't need Power BI license for this. You just register on Power BI, go to apps, get data. There will be a source called Microsoft Project Web. Add that, it understands how to do the needful. And then out of the box, you get the combined dashboard of all the projects' live status. Earlier, Microsoft Project itself had an internal engine for reporting, which they have replaced with Power BI for enterprise reporting. Now these reports are showing you various things. If you don't like them, you can completely customize them using Power BI Desktop for free. If you want to share the reports, yes, there is a license required. For creating reports, there is no license required. This is one view. This is overall project status. Another view is costs. It shows you costs, variance, and by project, what is the cost. Again, all this is fully customizable. Another option is to go to Power BI Desktop, use the atom feed or the REST feed from Project Online API and create your reports completely from scratch. This is upcoming milestone. This is very commonly done. What are the upcoming tasks? It's a very common report when there is a PMO review. That also comes automatically. And this is to know who is doing what, if in case you are interested. So by person, group by person, what is the work they are doing. And all this can be scheduled to be refreshed. So I have put a daily refresh. So no extra effort is involved. Whenever you go to this report, it is live and updated. And remember, Power BI comes as a Power BI app as well. So bosses don't have to go to a browser. This is always available on their mobile. Now all this was enterprise reporting. Enterprise means all reports across projects. But still, complex projects require project-specific reporting as well, which is not available on project online. That happens inside project. Now, the simplest thing we do is, I have saved a baseline and now the project is progressing. So this is called tracking Gantt, which is a built-in feature for any project management tool. What does it do? The gray one shows you what is planned and the red one or blue one shows you what is real. So this was planned to happen on Tuesday. It got postponed and its duration has increased and it is 33% complete. Like that. Red color means it's a critical task. If this task gets delayed, project will get delayed. This is one view, but there is a very sophisticated report menu right within desktop, and you can create custom reports as well as use ready-made reports. So I'll show you a couple of them. This is the dashboard called Project Overview. This is only specific to this project. So it shows you overall picture, upcoming tasks, late tasks, stuff like that. Project complete. This is cost overview. This is cost, remaining cost, complete, and this shows you sort of a cumulative burn down. In fact, there is a separate burn down report, which is very commonly required in project management context. This is work analysis. And finally, many of you, I'm sure you have spent enormous amount of time in PowerPoint creating such timelines manually. Am I right or wrong? These are automatic. So let me show you how easy it is to create a timeline. So I go to project. I have a project. By default, this timeline is not visible. This is, you see task, you see Gantt chart. That's default. Now if you go to view, there is a timeline option. So if you enable that, you see the timeline. Of course, it is blank, but what do? You right click on any task and say add to timeline. So I say task 1, add to timeline, it will get added. You can change its formatting, you can customize it. Typically people put milestones also on the timeline. Timeline always shows the entire project duration. You can zoom in, zoom out, and go to a particular part of the project as well. You can format individual aspects of the timeline by changing colors, fonts, and so on. Once you are happy with the timeline, there is a copy button. But this is a very special copy button. You say copy for presentation. Then you go to PowerPoint, add a new slide, and paste it. Now many times after pasting the timeline, we want to tweak it for whatever reasons. So you have a choice. It actually gives you individual objects. You don't like those individual objects, you can press the control and say paste it as picture. So in few seconds, you got a nice looking timeline. And of course, you can update it anytime you want. So I guess that's all the time I have. So to summarize, all I'm saying is don't use spreadsheets. It's a bad idea, not just because it's wasting your time, it's giving you wrong information. Use some kind of project management tool, whichever you use, whichever you like. Make sure whatever you use, projects are auto-consolidated without manual copy-paste. Enable live reporting. Any tool which supports this will give you live reporting. And ensure that resources themselves update the progress. Because they are the ones doing the work, that's why they should update the progress. This works very well when you outsource the project to an external entity. There are only a couple of people in your own organization. Everything is outsourced. You should include external parties in the update progress. Even if it means you have to buy a couple of licenses, it's absolutely worth it. Because once project management is done properly, people can't hide behind the inefficiencies of updates. Once project management is live, it is very easy to understand where the fault was, whose fault was it, and take corrective action well in advance. So finally, if you do this, project managers can actually focus on managing projects rather than copy-paste. So that's all I have time for. Thank you.